Hey guys, Zolart here, back again with another review, and today we are taking a look at the Marvel Legends X-Men Age of Apocalypse. Is it an exclusive? Because so far, at least in my area, these have only popped up at Target. I don't know if they're supposed to hit Walmarts or what, but I swear I saw this on like Entertainment Earth and BBTS, places like that. I don't know. I can't keep track. Hasbro makes too much shit. So, with that being said, today we're taking a look at Apocalypse, of course, because that just makes sense for Age of Apocalypse. They did the Sugar Man wave, which kind of sold poorly, because those are just hanging out up here, and meanwhile I'm trying to find Strong Guy and can't do it, because there's just Sugar Man everywhere, which, honestly, I think Sugar Man's better of the two Baffs, but I think the Strong Guy wave in general is probably a better wave overall, especially because of that Pirate Deadpool. Yeah, I said it! But as far as this guy's accessories go, he doesn't come with a lot. He should have come with a buzzsaw and a drill hand, maybe. Because we need more Apocalypse constructs. We don't have enough of those. But whatever. He comes with this laughing head, which looks kind of stupid to me. I don't know. It's okay, but I don't know, it just looks too goofy. I feel like Apocalypse is too serious of a dude to be laughing like this. He looks like a... Looks more like MODOK than Apocalypse to me, but that's just me. And then he also comes with this turn your head and cough hand, which is one of my favorite hand sculpts of all time. Just the pose, not really this hand in particular, because I get to make that joke in almost every video that has a hand like this, and that's funny. I'm saying right now his hand's hinge up and down, or in and out, I should say. But they're just really tight. As you can hear, this one's got a nice tight ratchet on it. So, yeah. And then for the turn your head and cough hand, he comes with a skull, which does not have a peg hole on the bottom, which sucks because I wanted to put this on another figure. But you can place it in the hand like so. However, if you're going to be gripping a skull, your pointer finger should probably be in the hole that's kind of made for it. Yeah. I guess they weren't thinking about that. So, whatever. It is a nicely painted skull, too, which is a shame. No hinged jaw, either. I don't think so. Yeah, it's just a solid skull. Which, I don't know if that's from a comic book cover or something, but that's pretty much it. And, honestly, this kind of sucks. So, looking at the rest of the figure here. This is like the third time I'm doing this review, because the first time the lighting was terrible, the second time this whole upper torso ensemble shoulder pad cape mess thing was a big fat pain in the ass, so here we are. His cape does detach from the shoulder pads, it just pegs into the back of each one via these little pegs, and he just died. Via the little pegs on the cape. And then as far as the shoulder pads go, they are just connected via these little friction hinges. They are not very difficult to pop out. And of course you get one for each side. They're both different, so if you get two of the same one, you're kind of screwed. And then he's got this collar piece, which you just pull up over his head. It's got these two pegs there. Woo! Bopping the camera. Professionalism! He's got two pegs on his neck. One right there. And then he's got two slots on his shoulders. One right there, and one right there. So you can peg all that stuff in. And because he is a Build-A-Figure, you could also do this. Pop his arm out. Which on this side... It's fine, you know, pegs in. It's whatever. But this side, at least on mine, it's a little stress mark there. But when I popped it out to adjust this bicep, because it was kind of sitting funny on that joint, and it was kind of gappy, it did not take a lot of effort to pop this out. And thinking about the four sides of a square here, it's only got stress on one side of the four, so I'm pretty sure I did not cause that. It was caused when it was made. So, be wary about that. Hashtag don't break your toys. Blah, blah, blah. This head sculpt, though, is amazing. I'm tempted to put that on the old Build-A-Figure, but I don't think the old one's supposed to have this kind of dark blue on the top. I think it's supposed to be more black, or is it black? I guess it is kind of. It's dark enough, I suppose. Could work. Let's see. I don't have that one handy, unfortunately, otherwise I'd do that head swap right now. But the head, just a simple ball peg, pretty easy to pop off too. Hinges up and down. Snaps in pretty easily. He can look down that far. He can look up that far. He's got a little bit of play in that ball peg, but he doesn't have a lot of attitude. He's got a little bit, though. And he can rotate side to side, of course. Shoulders hinge out to the side like so. Focus in here. Then back down, forward and back, swivel at the bicep, hinge at the elbow, and if you're like me, you can adjust the gauntlets and get a little bit more range. All you gotta do is pop them out to the front to where they are lined up with kind of the knuckle of his hand. If you don't do that, they'll be like midway to his hand, and you won't get a ton of elbow hinge out of that. He's got a swivel at the wrist. As well as a hinge, but of course, like I said, it is a little tight on mine, so you're just gonna have to go by the other hand that I showed earlier. Ab crunch moves that far back and that far forward, back into place. Waist swivel, nice tight waist swivel, which is something I think Marvel Legends needs more of. A lot of the ones lately seem to have kind of loose waists, but this one's nice and tight. There's no stupid mold lines making it all gappy, too. Hips go out to the side further than freaking Spider-Man, so that's cool. And they kick forward that far. Back, not so much. He's got a thigh cut. Double joint at the knee. Can almost kick his own ass. Almost. He's got a boot cut. And as I showed before, hinge at the foot with a rocker. So, getting all of his junk back on can be easier said than done. I'm gonna pop his head off and I'm gonna just kind of do this gradually here. So this collar piece should easily peg in, but it does not, clearly. You gotta kind of warp it a bit, and yeah, it's very cumbersome to work with because I'm pretty sure these peg holes were dremeled in here after the fact. I don't know if that's part of the mold. They don't feel like they are. They feel like they're an afterthought. But on mine in particular, if you peg this side in, then this side, it sits on there just fine. And then you can take the head push it on there. There you go. I would probably recommend gluing this. All honesty, probably save you some trouble. Because you're probably not going to take it apart like I did for this review. And then the shoulder pads, you got to find the peg hole, which needs to be facing the back. So this is this side. Is that it? Ah, there we go. And then the other side goes on here like so, and then flipping him over to the back. His cape is a little tricky, but it can be done. I noticed this side is the easier side to peg in first, and then this side. And there you go. There is Apocalypse in all of his shiny blue glory, which I must say, I do like the shiny blue. Cool looking figure. I don't know. I get a Lex Luthor vibe from this figure for some reason. I'm not sure why, but I just do. It's very cool. It's very big, very imposing. Probably the better of the Age of Apocalypse figures. I mean, it is Apocalypse. That's his thing. It very well should be the better of the Age of Apocalypse figures. I hope we get some more. As much as I'm kind of not that much into X-Men right now, I think a saber tooth, a cyclops, a gambit, a rogue. I don't know who else was in that whole spiel, but I think those would be ideal choices for future releases. At least Sabretooth to go with Wild Child. Maybe Cyclops to go with Jean. But size comparison, here he is next to Spawn, who's a way better figure in every way. And here he is next to Ghost Rider, who he dwarfs. Appropriately so. And let's just take a second to talk about Spawn here. This is a $20 figure. More articulation, better sculpt, better paint. Comes with a quote unquote usable accessory. I mean, this figure comes with a hand, a head, and a skull that he doesn't hold correctly, and the head looks kind of derpy. So, yeah, Spawn might not come with as much accessories, but this is the better figure overall. Figure of the year, possibly. I don't know how long this virus is going to delay my Kickstarter Spawn, but that can hurry up. But with that being said, I would recommend this figure if you like the Age of Apocalypse stuff. If you missed out on the Apocalypse Build-A-Figure, I would maybe say try and get that one, because this is a very specific look for Apocalypse. But seeing this, I could see a 90s Apocalypse on the horizon, because it's got those colors. Technically, this is a 90s Apocalypse, though, isn't it? But yeah. So that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Stay tuned, I got plenty of stuff coming. I have plenty of videos recorded. It's just I like to kind of I don't know, keep up with the times. I want to review some fresh stuff, keep things fresh. Kind of like Subway, except not like Subway, because we don't serve sandwiches. But yeah, that being said, till next time, I'll catch you guys later. Anyone else think this guy has some weird blue carp lips? I always did.